Dwayne here, phoenixtypewriter.com. We're going to put the hub back in the IBM Selectric 2 today. So, let's bring our camera up and see what we got here. We've got our parts here. We're going to install these all today. So we're going to start with, over here on the side is the old hub. And the bushing is cracked, so we're just going to replace the bushing and the hub, of course. There's our split right there. That should not have a split. Should not be a gap right there. Okay. That hub is bad. The bushing is bad. Here's our replacement hub. It's modified with metal. It's all sealed up. Good for 30 more years. Here's the bushing. I'm actually going to do a little trick on this right here. While we got it, I'm going to ream the inside of this edge of this new bushing just a little bit with the razor. I'm just going to cut this around. And I'm just going to taper the inside of this so it goes in smoother. Sometimes it likes to hang up on this inner ring, so I like to get the edge tapered and then put it in place here. Go ahead and stick this like that. And then a little bit of oil in here. Bit around the edge here. And everything should be good. Okay, that's ready to go in. Let's take a look at what we got here. So we're going to have the pulley going first. Belt goes in next. Swing arm goes in next. Retainer clip. Operational shaft with the clutch, all the retainers, cycle clutch trip, retainer, gear pack. By the way, this is a 13-inch model, and it's got a smaller gear pack than the standard 15-inch. Same deal, but shorter by 2 inches. So I got this to sort of show you what a 15 looks like, and it's brand new. Spins like a top. It's a brand new piece. But that doesn't fit our machine. We've got this little guy. And it spins. Alright, I flushed it out and re-lubed it. Ready to go. Retainers and safety cap. So let's put some of this stuff aside and we're gonna start. Right here, right now. Hopefully get this to show up on videotape. So let me turn some more light on here. There we go. And get some more light positioned. And let's look down in here a little bit. Okay. So you know the hub goes in center shaft here. I've already cleaned this and lubed it. So it's ready to go. So we can just drop this in right now. Excuse me. And there we go. Okay, so that goes in pretty smooth. And all we got to do is get it lined up. So you got to move this. Let me move this carrier a little more out of the way here. Kind of manipulate this with the hand cycle tool. And get that shaft to go on that bushing first, and then you line up those teeth. Those, you know, once you get it past the bushing, then you gotta line up these pegs in the proper spot. You turn this until it matches. So it takes a little bit of getting this just right, but it'll go. It will go when we get it just right. And this one is being a little stubborn. There it goes. There it goes. And once you get it in there, the gap here should be, well, about that much of a gap. Maybe enough for an IBM tool to get into right next to it, right? Yeah, perfect. See that? I think that was meant to be, but I'm not sure. You just got to get it flush in there. Some stick out a little more than others, I think. I don't think that's the most critical thing. So next we're going to slip the belt on and just bring it around the pulley here in the back. Like that. And go ahead and run it back on the pulley here. Like that. And we can plug the machine in and make sure that's spinning freely. Okay. All right, she's going there. You can check and see if that hub is good. You can go ahead and like hit the carriage return, hold the carrier. And sounds good. Sounds like it's making a little bit of noise. Let's see. A couple drops of oil in there. I'm going to see if I can determine if that's making noise. I think everything's all right. I see what the problem is. I see. Let's go ahead and fix that. The spring is off the clutch here, right here. I don't know. I probably knocked that off. Taking the belt off or on. Off or on. Off, on or off. Get the spring connected. Okay, let's try that. Okay, clutch is working right. Turn this guy around. So next thing we do is put in the swing arm. Goes on the shaft right here. And that's a pretty tight fit sometimes, but we'll, it should go on there. Let's get this. There it goes. And then we go ahead and stick it through the selection arms right here. Raise that up. Okay, there it goes. So that's in. And we'll go ahead and put that stud that goes in there. While we're at it here, while we're at that spot, we'll go ahead and stick the stud in this arm. Just gotta manipulate it till you find the spot for it. Come on. It's not finding the spot. There it goes. Okay, stud is back in there proper. And let's see what's next. Let's go ahead and stick the operational shaft in. And I think I showed you the trick to this before. We need to collapse the rack here. We're just going to do that by propping the screwdriver in here. And we're just going to go full on here. Hold that rack down. All right. This is my little trick. I'm not sure how other people do it, but okay, operational shaft. Of course, this piece is the top. This is the front where the dust cover mount goes, and this mount has nothing but a screw, so goes in like that. Make sure your collar's in there proper. In fact, I had to reposition this clutch. It wasn't flush up against the cam here. Probably that way from day one. So I think this is the original pulley. Maybe the original clutch. Okay, when you're sticking the shaft in, let's take a look here. Get this camera a little angled a little different. Typewriter angled, okay. You can stick this, you can get that in there first. See that shaft moving right there? You can get that started in there. Perfect. And now you've got to push those link, that one link out of the way. Another thing I'm going to do is move this spring over here. This little spring out of the way. Okay, so there is a link down here. That's right there. Push that down to get it past the cam, past it. And there, it slides right on in. Okay, so this is going in, and got the end cap properly lined up here, so let's go ahead and push this the rest of the way. And you got to kind of move this collar to make everything go on here. Oops, I got to move this link again. Wasn't quite all the way in. Come on. Hanging up here a little bit. I think it's the clutch edge here. Spring is. Alright. Alright, just coming back out. I think something is not right here. Spring out of the way again. Okay. This collar got off. It's out of place here. Gotta be in there right, or it's not gonna want to go in. Let's try it again. Okay, shaft in there. And I'm gonna move the link out of the way here. Okay, there it goes on much better. Right to the right flush, and if everything is right, this collar on the end cap here will be flush over here. Let's get the spring out of the way and see if that's flush. Come on. Ah, it is. So yeah, the collar, if it's flush against the frame here, we've got a positive fit. So let's flip this up a little bit. Take a look at the... So this is nice and flush, and it's ready to put the mounting screws in. So let's line up the holes a little bit. There we go. And we'll put the bottom one in at least. Start with this one. And I'm I'm just gonna back it off a little bit. This next one is a little tricky. I think I showed you this on the belt removal. So this piece has to go, screw has to go through here, and then that mounts against the frame, and then this hangs on the inside. And you gotta get some. So it goes right there. And put your fingers around there. It'll help manipulate it around. And right there. So we've already got it started. Good job. This piece has a lot of adjustment on it right here, but just kind of center it to. Just kind of center it and start from there. If it needs some adjusting, we'll do it later. Okay, next one is top one, which you can't see from this angle. Move something here. There it is right there. So let's that also has a piece on it like that, so that goes in. I'm gonna use a tool, I think, to send it on in there. It's definitely more difficult with a camera right in my face. Okay, that goes up like that. And let's tighten this up a little bit. Sometimes that's a screw, sometimes it's a quarter inch nut type of thing. And this piece has to be up out of the way, because the gear pack's got to get on here, so the gear pack's got to go right in here. And let's see what to do next. I think we're going to go ahead and put it in cycle clutch trip arm. We left the top screw in, so it just sits in there in the bracket like this. We're going to use the top screw as a. And that is pretty tricky to see from the camera angle, but you can see that bracket where it goes right there. There's the cutout right there for the top screw. Pretty difficult to see on the camera. So just get this down in here, manipulate it onto that mount, make sure the washer's on the right side, and this might need adjusting when it's all said and done. Okay, she's in there, and we're going to go ahead and put the bottom mount screw in. That's even more difficult to see than the first one. Okay. Get this lined up. Okay, so it is way in there. I'm going to try to shine the light on it. so you can see. Okay, so it's right there where the light's at, that screw hole right there. We got to aim for that. And we're going to use the long screwdriver. I don't know if I showed you when you pull that bottom nut out to cut the screw head so you can put a screwdriver in there a little deeper, because it's got a very shallow slot, and has a tendency to not want to stay. So let's I'm just gonna have to do this. Don't think I can really hold the camera and get this in here. Okay. And just got to get it started. Tighten it up a little bit. Okay, there she goes. Okay, so it's just a little snug, because that's going to need adjusting for sure. This arm gets connected to that piece, that little stud right there. So this arm goes in that stud. And we're going to go ahead and put a C-clip on that, because it has a tendency to come off when we're doing the adjustment. So that's up in there. Let's get this on. Well, let's try this some more. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and put the stud in here. Right here, this pivot arm selection, and let's go ahead and just put the nut on the back. Tighten this up on our final tight run. Okay, so let's spin the clutch here and see if everything is turning properly. Good, it latched up. Let's trip it right here. There we go. It should cycle around, but it's not. It's clutch. It's out of adjustment here or something. Alright, something's out of adjustment. So I should have cycled. Should have cycled around. Alright, let's adjust a clutch in here. Which is going to be a real difficult thing to show, but I'm going to go ahead and do it, and then we'll see if we can show it later. I had to adjust that collar when I adjusted the getting that spring back in place, so it's probably out of adjustment a little bit. So I'm gonna loosen the collar, loosen this up a little, and we're gonna move this whole collar down a little. That and tighten it back up. Let's see if that runs it around now. Let's strip this again. Nope, it doesn't like what's happening here. Again, it looks like this collar is came back. I ended up reversing this clutch spring in here and adjusting the collar. It was not engaging properly, so we're going to put it back in now. Hopefully some closer adjustment than it was a few minutes ago. And let's get back to this. So we're going to drop the shaft in here. Let's see if okay, remember we got this. This side is the high side. And let's just stick it through the shaft, and we're going to get the shaft in there first. Okay. Push the link out of the way. Which is right there. Let it slide back in the rest of the way. I went ahead and left the trip arm in here. You can definitely do that. And then manipulate this little collar. We'll get this to so clutch turn this and get this to seat. Come on. It's not going in like it should. It's in there. Let's make sure this collar is flat. So that way we can tell it's all the way in. Okay. Tis. Collar's flat against the frame over here. So let's put the mounts in again. Try it one more time. Sometimes this takes more than once to do. Okay, so we're back over here. I'm going to throw this bottom screw in first, like we did before. Okay. Let's just stick this one in first. Then we got to manipulate this little guy in there. So we'll take a shot at that. That one is a little trickier. But it can be done. We do it all the time. There we go. Stick this up and over. The edge. Come on. There it goes. There. And then the screw started. Just like that. And we'll zip this back on the rest of the way. Again, just kind of center this this little bracket tab here. And we'll fine-tune it later if necessary. Okay, so it's kind of centered. Just snug that up a little bit. And we'll put the top guy in right there. So that's this piece here. That goes through there. And let's see if I can get this in with just my finger. Okay. Perfect. And we'll tighten this down. And move this safety piece up out of the way until we put the gear pack on there. There we go. So it's out of the way so we can stick the gears on. Next, I think we can do that. Let's cycle the machine and make sure that clutch is in there right. So now, I have already adjusted the trip arm here since I had it apart, so it should actually fire up here. And we should be able to hit a key and it shouldn't just run continuous here. perfect. Alright, what I need to do to just turn the filter shaft, reset the interposer. Now we'll stop. Perfect. And let me check the timing here. So we want this shaft at about 1 o'clock. That's noon, let's say 1 o'clock right there. And I'm going to go ahead and put the this little backup piece here. This can tell you if it's in adjustment two. So let's put that in. There's a spring under here. Right there, and then this piece goes on that shaft, and the spring goes underneath, piece goes on, and that's it right there. Now this should latch up if everything's right, so let's cycle this around and see if that latches up. Yeah. Good. This is pretty close here, so it's what we wanted. It's what we got. Okay, and oh, spinning nice and freely, so no binds, no other adjustments needed at the moment. Let's get under here and change the make sure the filter shaft is exactly where I want it. That's this shaft, and I want it just in front of the interposers. So, those are the interposers right here, and you just want to be able to make sure those can go down and as close as possible. So let's just leave it right there for now. And we're going to put the gear pack on over here. This can always be a little tricky. Get it right. So, remember, this is a small one for the 13-inch model versus the 15-inch model. Same deal though. We need to get it into these two gears and make sure the mesh is about right, and then we're going to line it up to this gear, and then we're going to line it up to these holes. And hopefully it kind of stays in time. So get it in those back two gears and slide it in there, and then I think that's pretty good right there. And we're going to line these two holes up. There's a little bit of wiggle room and adjustment right there, but if everything's right, it's about centered on those holes, and the gear meshes, you know, should be pretty even. So the holes, you can kind of see the outline of it right there. So it was right there before. Let's try to put it right there again. Alright, let's give this a try here. I'm just going to snug this one up a little bit. Very little, and position this so we can get to the other one. There we go. Now, there should be very, very little play in these gears. I mean, you don't want them binding, but you don't want them sloppy. Oh, that's a little too much. So we're gonna close the gap there. Tighten this up just a little more. Just a hair. So I can manipulate this. Perfect. Okay. I think we're going to go with that. Crank these screws down because you don't want this coming loose. All right, let's cycle this thing. Let's just do it right here. Everything's right. This is work. Looks good. Oh, I think the filter shaft is off just a little bit, but let's check the gear mesh here. Still seems a little tight here. Seems a little looser. I'm going to give this just a little more tweaking, I think. Okay, that seems a little better. Tighten this up. Tight. And let's run it again. Okay, good. Good. And good. So there's just a little bit, you can probably see this move just a little bit right here. That may be a little too much, but I think it's... it's a within tolerance, let's say. So let's see if the flute shaft or the filter shaft is about right. Let me just get some light in here. So let's clean off a little gap right there. And we'll clean the other side. And we're going to use that interposer right here as a... we can see this a little better. Yep. A little bit of air in here. Clean that off a little bit. Let's cycle that around. Okay. So, I'm going to unplug this and we're going to drop an interposer in here. So I'm going to trip an interposer right there and we're going to see how close it is to the filter shaft. It's too close. It's bumping the filter shaft. See if you can see that. There it went pie, but we need to adjust this shaft counterclockwise just a little bit. And we trip this off here. So we power this bug up. Going to trip this a few times. Yeah, we need to move that just a fraction. And we're going to do that over here on this gear. We're going to turn this till the set screw show up right there. Now, I got to find me a wrench. I know I got one over here. Let's try this one. We'll loosen these up a little bit. And we're going to just back that shaft off a little bit. It's part of the initial timing. Well, the initial timing starts at the cycle clutch, but that is okay. Okay, so that's loose. And what we're going to do is move the shaft. I'm going to hold the gear with my hand so I know it's stationary. And we're going to manipulate the shaft back a little bit. Right like that, right? Just a hair. And we're going to come tighten these up, and we're going to try it. Best to try this under power. Hand cycling will not give you a true placement of the timing. Alright, just need to snug these up for our test. Okay, let's give this a try. So, we want that to just I don't think I went enough. I'm not sure I went anything. And it's still too close for me. I'll come back over and give this another try. Let's just loosen this up. Loosen that. And I'll try moving it again. Okay, I know I got some movement now, so hopefully it didn't go too far. I'm just going to tighten this one bottom tight. Take a look, see. Oh, that's so close. I still think it's too close. I'm going to try it one more time here. Not sure I'm getting movement out of this. Okay. Okay, let me try that one more time. Okay, let's see. I think that's going to do it. Okay, so you just need to clear the filter shaft and make sure the shaft does not have any play when everything is good. Now let's come up and check one more thing. We might have this running. Let's check the top shaft. Looks good. It's at about 1 o'clock right here. So that's in about the right position. I think we can try this. Just give it a quick little try. All right, let's see what happens here. Good. I think the shaft appears too far forward. Let's check the dash underscore. Oh, it might be all right. I need to adjust the factor clutch. I'm going to go ahead and fine tune that off camera. It is way too tricky to try to explain. It is doubling up here. See, when it typed the dash. You know, so I need to fine-tune the cycle clutch. Cycle clutch on here is doubling up. So it's going 2 cycles. Or sometimes. There it goes. It's just a fine adjustment in the trip here in the clutch. Otherwise, I think we've got the pulley back in there and working and pretty close to proper adjustment. Let's go ahead and finish up everything here that we need to tighten up and call this a done. So yeah, go ahead and tighten up the end cap all the way and make sure that's tight. And quarter inch nut up here can get tightened. Okay, the nut down here in the bottom of your swing arm needs to be tightened up. good. Okay, there's the bottom mount of this has got to be tightened up. It's already kind of tight, but we're going to crank on it here a second. Get it tighter. It's hard to get in there, but it can be done. Okay. That's done. I'm going to tighten up the top nut on the trip, and it's right. You can almost see it on the camera right there. That top nut is right there, and we're going to tighten that up. Alright, we got these tight. We can go ahead and put the safety cap on here. And just put the nut on here. And two more quick things to do, and we'll be done with this procedure for the most part. Is put the clip back on.